Today I'm going to teach you guys how to record all of your conversations on Discord and or Skype, so you can use these conversations to win arguments later on down the road, or extort people for money. Just kidding. Let's get undone. Gerald Undone. He's crazy. What is happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and today we've got a question from the YouTube comments. Remember I was saying in the other video to send me your questions, and I will do my best to help test some things out, answer some questions, do whatever I can, solve your problems for you. Well, we've got one today from LT Soon, LT Soone, Lieutenant Soon. Sorry if I'm getting your name wrong. It says, question for you for future video, how to best record a conversation via Skype or Discord to use for a collab slash gaming video. Never really gotten it to work in a nice way. So this is a great question. Thank you so much for submitting it. And I think I have a pretty good solution for you that should work for pretty much anybody who watches this video. Anybody that wants to record some sort of audio thing that's going on their computer, I found a pretty easy way to do that. And this is going to be for a computer tutorial, but it doesn't matter whether you're on PC, Mac, whatever. But I've just got a couple of disclaimers for you, especially with the joke that I made at the beginning of the video. Number one, don't record people without their consent. It's creepy. Don't do it, okay? And the second thing is the quality, no matter what steps we go through in this video, the quality is always going to be, you know, by its weakest link, which means the person that you're speaking to, it doesn't matter how good your hardware is, if their hardware is junk, it's going to affect the quality. And then the second thing is going to be the quality of the call itself. So if you're using Discord or Skype or something else, and your connection is wavering, or you're getting that weird robotic thing, that you're going to record that. Now, obviously, most people are understanding of this, but just the way that it's going to be, that you can't expect better quality than what the call is producing itself. But within that, we can try to capture that to as much, you know, keep as much of that quality as possible that was in the call. Okay, so moving on how to do it. Okay, so for this tutorial, I'm going to recommend that you use OBS Studio. Now, I know a lot of you probably know that I'm a big fan of OBS, but you're also thinking to yourself, but Gerald, OBS is also video. It's not just audio only. And that's true. So you're going to have to remove the video afterwards or just overwrite the video with your gameplay footage if you're trying to do the collab thing or whatever your other purpose is. You know, you can always just record a black screen and then delete the video in your editor. It doesn't really matter. But the reason why I like to use OBS is one, it's free, it's easy. There is a plethora of information out available on it. And it's useful for other instances that you might want to do this voice thing on Discord as well. Maybe you're streaming, or maybe you're doing a podcast and you're not in person and you have to be able to record the other person's voice this way because they can't record it and send it to you. So you could use it for that streaming podcast, you know, pre-recorded gaming videos, whatever. OBS is kind of your friend. So it's better to get to know one program really, really well and then be able to use it for a lot of purposes, whether that includes video or not. Anyway, so just go to Google and type in OBS Studio. And it should be pretty easy. Go to the first link there, and you can see you can get it for Windows, Mac, Linux. So once you download that program, pop it open, and it should look a little something like this. Now, this weird, you know, inception thing that's going on, it's because I'm recording my screen, which is recording my screen and my screen, blah, 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 and all the way down. But ignore the main box here, and let's just look along the bottom. The reason why this is going to work with Discord or anything else is, as you can see here, you've got desktop audio in the mixer. And then below that, we've got our mic. Now, in here, in the mixer, you can control the mic stuff. If you hit the cog and you choose filters, you can add filters and effects to your mic, and if you choose properties, you can change the device type right in here if you have multiple mics hooked up. And then also if you choose advanced audio properties, this is where you're going to have the option to add a change the volume levels, pan it left or right. If you're using a mono microphone like I am, you're going to want to hit down mix to mono, that way the microphone isn't only coming in through the left channel, but it's going to be split to the left and the right. And you can also put a sync offset in here, which is, I feel like a lot of people don't know about this function in OBS because I hear a lot of complaints about when they're trying to record video with OBS that it's not synced up. You can put the offset in here so that if you find that your video source and your audio source aren't lined up, you can line it up right there, which is great for streaming. And then you're going to want to enable, this is going to come in the settings, you're going to want to enable your tracks across the board here so that you have these options. If you don't want certain devices to not be available in certain tracks, then you can uncheck them. This is just there for you to customize. But I pretty much use desktop audio and the microphone and pretty much everything I record, so that's why they're checked all the way across. Now, when we look at the levels down here, you can see that as I talk, the microphone is popping up. When you're talking to somebody on Discord, their part of the call is going to come in here on desktop audio, and it's going to pop up this way. And then you can use your levels in here, or you can use the levels in Skype or Discord, the user volume control, to try and get it so that your levels are about even if you want to sound like you have a similar volume to your voice. So you might want to bring yourself down this way or bring them up, until, and then you can do that same thing. Like I said, if you go into desktop audio now and you were to choose advanced audio properties, you can increase the desktop audio volume percent. You can make it 200%, 300%, whatever. And that will increase their volume. They're going to be on desktop audio and you're going to be on mic. And you can kind of give a little pre-mix mastering there so that when you record it, you're a bit more even. Because when we do record it, we're not going to be recording separate audio streams. Unless you record your voice separately from the Discord voice and then try to mix them afterwards, but that's going to add even more to your workflow. So, you know, the easiest way to go about doing it would be this way. Try to get the mix right and then just record it as one file type. Now, when it comes to how we're going to record that, on the right-hand side here under controls, you can hit settings and jump down to output and go to recording. And now in here, you're going to minor grade out because I'm actively recording, but you're going to choose a location of where you want it to record, a recording format. MP4 is probably the most flexible file container. And then the encoder, I would use X264 because if your computer isn't doing much other than recording this audio thing, you don't have to worry about it. And then the output and stuff like that isn't that important either. Now there is something I have here in the custom mixer settings, which I'll put in the description so you can copy and paste it if you want. Basically, it's when you're recording to an MP4 file. That actually kind of says it right here. Recording saved to MP4 will be unrecoverable if the file cannot be finalized. So if your power shuts off or your OBS has to hard crash before the file's saved, then the MP4 will be lost. If it doesn't finish, you don't get any part of it. So if you put this thing in, basically what it does is it puts like keyframe flags throughout the video so that you can recover every so many seconds as you record. So it's a useful setting to have just paste it in there. So I'll put that in the description, copy paste that in there. Then down here, I just have this set up basically to like max out. So if you put the rate control on variable bitrate and then just type in all nines for the bitrate, that'll basically say it'll use as much bits as it needs to for a local recording. Because we're not streaming this, right? We're just saving it locally. So it doesn't really matter how big the file is for the most part, especially if it's just audio. So just fill that up with nines. Use custom buffer size, type 0 for the buffer size. Put a CRF of 18, should be fine. And then 0, ultra fast, profile high, tune none. You can just pause it here and make yours match to this. But you put this in and you'll basically just get a pretty, you know, one-to-one recording of the audio as it's coming in. Now you'll notice up here next to audio track, I have track 2 checked. That's because I use different settings for different tracks, and these are set under the audio tab. So if we go to the audio tab, track 2 has an audio bitrate of 320. It's because when I stream or do something that I need to have a smaller file size, I might set the audio bitrate, like as you can see in track 1, down to 160. But if I'm trying to actually record something and I want to preserve as much as possible, I'm not really worried about the file size, so I set the bitrate up to 320. But I know this is track 2. You could put 320 as track 5, and then in recording, choose track 5. Say that's the track I want to use for this recording. And then you're getting your maximum audio quality that you can get. And then you're good to go. And that's pretty much all you have to do to set up the audio part for OBS. Once you have it all set up, this over here, as you can see, you have sources on the left-hand side down here. You hit plus and you can put all your different sources in here. I have display capture, so it captures everything that's going on my monitor right now. And that's fine for Discord, whatever, because you're not really gonna use the video anyway. But even if you turned that off, you would have only a black screen, which is gonna make the file size smaller, and you're still gonna get the same audio stuff here. Then you just go ahead and press start recording over on the right here, and have your conversation on Discord. And then, you know, maybe start the call a little previous and get them to talk and say, oh, just count to 10. And then they count to 10, you count to 10, and just get your levels right, and then record it. Once it's recorded, you're gonna have an MP4 file with a video and an audio stream. But you said you were planning on editing this anyway, so you could put your game footage over top and then sync it up. So you pop it open in your whatever NLE editor you want to use, and throw your MP4 file that you recorded from OBS on there. Take your video footage. You know, you could sync it up along the timeline and then just copy it over it. Or you could unlink it and delete the video footage from the OBS file. It's really easy. You don't have to worry about the video file. Now, there are a lot of other ways to do this. There are audio programs you could use. I'm sure you could probably get it to work in Audacity or Audition or something like that. But I like OBS, like I said before, because you could also use these same settings. Once you get comfortable with it, you can stream with it. You can do it to capture other things, including video. Maybe you want to make a tutorial like this one. I recorded this entire thing, the desktop parts, on OBS to show kind of how it's good to get to know a program, especially a free program that pretty much everybody can use. And it's got a lot of power behind it. So that's it basically for this. I hope that it was helpful to you, especially LT Soon. If you found that I missed something, there's something you're not really sure about, let me know in the comments and I will do my best to answer it there. If anybody else has any questions about this tutorial, also leave them in the comments. Or if any of you have anything else that you want help with, it doesn't have to be about this.
Is it possible for a 12-year-old boy to get pregnant from reading comic books?
Just anything in the creative tech space. Let me know those in the comments as well, and I will do my best to get to them, any ones that I think I can help with, in future videos. If you found this video helpful or entertaining, make sure you drop the old thumbs up. But if you did not find it helpful or entertaining, feel free to hit the dislike button twice. All right! I'm done.